joined this club. Maybe it was last week. Maybe tonight. Maybe 20 years ago. Why did you join Bits and Speeches? Why will you join Bits and Speeches? Is it to be a better communicator? Is it because you have to give presentations at work? Is it because you'd like to be a stronger leader? Or was it because you heard we use this amazing website called EasySpeak and you just couldn't wait to dive in and use it?
That was it for you, right now.
Yeah, that's what sold it, right? Right?
I'll tell the world.
For our newer members and guests, EasySpeak is the website that we use to create that agenda that's sitting on the table in front of you. It's the website that we use to schedule our speeches. It's the website we use to say, I'd like to be the awards master tonight. We manage our meetings on EasySpeak. It's a tool that helps us make all of this happen. As an individual member, it lets you take ownership of your journey in this club. And that's what I'd like to inspire you to do tonight, to use this tool to take ownership of your Toastmasters journey. And I'll show everyone how you do that. Sound fair? Mm-hmm. Awesome. I'm so glad we have so many new folks in the room. I think this will be really helpful for you, because when you're new and you go to EasySpeak, you log in and you look at it and you go, oh God, what did I get myself into? It's a little scary at first, but I promise by the time I'm done, you'll be thinking, it really is easy peasy. We're going to talk about four things today. How to get started on EasySpeak. How to say, I'd like to be the AwCounter tonight, taking a role. How to schedule a speech. And finally, I'll leave you with some advanced tips on EasySpeak for when you serve as Toastmaster of the meeting, because there is some extra when you are the Toastmaster of the meeting. Getting started. This is the hardest part. Go home. Go to your computer. Sit down and go to EasySpeak.org. That's the hardest part, right? When you go home, are you thinking, I got to go to EasySpeak and sign up for a role? You're not, right? Not at all. I got to go feed the dog, I got to do laundry, this and that. The hardest part is sitting down at your computer and logging on. When you go to the website, this is what you see. This is the login screen, and up in the top corner is where you log in. When you join this club, you'll get an email from our Vice President Education, Doug, who's not here tonight, but he will email you your username and your password. So you use the information you get from Doug and you log in on this screen. When you log in, this is what greets you. And then you think, oh dear, where do I click? Right? There's stuff everywhere that you can click on. It's not that bad. I'll show you the few spots that you do need to use. First, up in the top left corner of the screen, there is a menu bar that says Meetings. And everyone has a copy of this, by the way. I printed out copies of the presentation. Feel free to take notes. Under Meetings, there's a couple things that are really important that you can do. First, if you click on Calendar, that top button, you can see a calendar of all the Toastmasters clubs near you. So for us, we see Bits and Speeches, we see Pop Up, which is another club that Gary's in, we see our sister club, Speaking Machine. You can see all of their meetings. But in bold here, you'll see our meetings. So right now, you can go to any of our future meetings using the calendar. Make sense?
Yes.
Okay. The other thing you can do from this Meetings tab up here at the top is just go straight to the next meeting. These screenshots are a little old, but the meeting date listed here will always be the next meeting. So if you'd like to just go and look at the next meeting, you don't have to bother with the calendar. You can just click the next date, and that will take you straight to the meeting. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay. This is what a meeting looks We have the date up at the top. There's an indicator of whether or not you are attending the meeting. And you'll also notice your name at the top of the list over here. This list is everyone in the club. And the green and red are, yes, I'll be there, no, I won't. Or, I'm not sure, and you get the question mark. So to tell the Toastmaster whether or not you'll be there, you can use that button right there, yes, no, question mark. Or you can use the thumbs up top. Either one will work. That lets the Toastmaster know, I will be at the meeting, put me in for whatever role you need. I'm fair game, whatever you want. So our more seasoned people like me tend to do that because I truly don't care what role I play. Just stick me whatever you need, I'll do it, right? Gary, Lorna, we all do the same thing. I'll be there, put me where you need me. Make sense so far?
Yes.
A really important thing is if you won't be at a meeting, please, 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 please go in and hit no. Then the Toastmaster isn't calling you saying, Earl, can you please be my Table Topics Master? And Earl saying, well, no, because I'm going to be in Las Vegas. If you know you're going to Vegas, hop in here real quick and say, nope, can't be in that meeting. Just let everybody know. Makes life easier. So that's the basics. That's how you get started. Just tell us whether you're going to be here. Any questions on that before I move forward into roles? Awesome. So meeting roles. Let's say you know you would like to be grammarian. What do you do? There's a couple of things you can do. You can find out who the Toastmaster is, call them, tell them, or you can just put it in easy speak. So when you're on the meeting screen, and we're back to our standard meeting, we have everybody in the club on this side. Over here, we have what will become the agenda. It's not in the same order as the agenda. Don't ask me why. I did not make the website. It's in a random order, but everything that appears on the agenda is right here. And you'll notice that each role has either a name on it, or it just has a green thumbs up that says yes. So if you're on a meeting, and you know that you would like to take a role for that meeting, all you need to do is click on that thumbs up. Once you've clicked on that thumbs up, it will put your name in that spot, and then you click on it again, just to make sure. Anytime you see this little red exclamation point guy, that's saying, hello, look at me, I'm not sure, are you really sure, do you want to do this? And then you hit the thumbs up to tell it, yes, I really am sure, it wasn't an accident, it wasn't a misclick, I really, really do want to be listener next week. Make sense? Mm-hmm. So anytime you'd like to take a role, all you need to do is go to the meeting, click the thumbs up. You can do that for any role except speeches. We'll talk about speeches a little later. Okay. Earl.
So when I last went to Easy Speak, which was yesterday, most of the roles had the names of members with a question mark. Mm-hmm. Who put that in? What does it mean?
So what that means is that the Toastmaster has filled those roles, but those people have not confirmed yet. So as an individual member, I can go in and say I'd like to play a role. The Toastmaster for the meeting can also go in and slot people in there and then ask those people to confirm. And I'll show you guys how we do that a little later on. Does that answer your question? Kinda?
Sure.
I'll show you a screen later that looks just like that, so you'll see it a little better. Okay. Now let's say you're somebody who really likes to plan ahead. You opened up your Competent Leader Manual and you saw I need to be Grammarian and Timer and Table Topics Master to finish this project. I'd like to do those three roles this month. What do? Up at the top here, we have My Participation, right next to the meetings. When you go to My Participation, if you hit Sign Up for Meetings, it takes you to this nifty screen with the next four meetings on it. So if you know you need to be Timer, Grammarian, and Table Topics Master, on this screen you can see in one glance the next four meetings. and whether or not those roles are filled. And then you can take those roles on this screen right here. Just like the meetings, this screen shows the little green thumbs up, and you just hit that and you'll get the role. So if you'd like to plan ahead, you can plan the whole month at one time. Questions? Anything else before I move on to speeches? Wanda.
So in planning ahead, say I know that in 2 weeks I'm going to be out of town. Can I mark myself absent for that meeting?
Yes.
Please do.
Yes, absolutely. And then we know you won't be there, we won't put you in any roles. Did I see Rebecca?
Yeah. Are you supposed to bring your book manuals as well so you can have somebody doing something, I don't know, the explanation for it.
Yes, yes. Always bring your competent leader manual. Does anyone have one?
Yes.
Oh, good. I was afraid I was going to say that and then no one would have one. Let me borrow that, if I may.
That's down here.
The competent leader manual gives you credit for all of these meeting roles. And in every project, at the back, there is an evaluation sheet. Very similar to the speech evaluations, but a lot shorter. So when you are the grammarian, you give this book to someone else in the club, and it can be anyone. It could be Annabelle, who just joined last week. It doesn't matter who it is at all, just not a guest, any member. Give them this book and ask them to fill it out for you, and they'll evaluate your performance as grammarian. Now, the way you get the most out of this book, though, is by actually reading the project first and then playing the roles. Because every project starts with what your objective is. So this is on listening. So this page talks about how to be a better listener, which for a lot of us is really challenging, right? Has anyone been the listener and really struggled with that? It's harder than we imagine. So this gives us all the tips on how to be a good listener, and then when you play the roles that require listening and get evaluated, they're evaluating you on those tips in this book. So read it, bring it to the meeting, and have somebody evaluate you. Have anybody here evaluate you. Make sense? Mm-hmm. Okay. I probably totally just went overkill on the question, huh?
No, that was totally very clear.
Good. Yeah. Jacob.
Yes, is it frowned upon to, for example, book the same role for 4 weeks, consecutive weeks?
I wouldn't recommend that because you might get tired of it. Yeah.
There wouldn't be a concept of getting better at it every week?
You could. I would suggest giving a week off to see how somebody else does it and then going back to it. So maybe every other week. So if you really thought the grammarian role was awesome, I'd do it once and then wait a week or two and do it again.
Could you take us to the screen where you can advance to the next meeting? Like she mentioned, she's going to be gone in 2 weeks. How would you advance to that meeting?
Sure. So we started with how to get to a meeting, right? And that was up here using this meetings button. Mm-hmm. When you are in a meeting, you have a previous button and you have a next button. So at any time from this meeting, you can go to next week. And you can keep cycling through until you get to the one you want. Or you can use the calendar, which again is accessed through that meetings button, and then click on whatever day it is you know you won't be here.
And also just go into the My Participation, because that has 4 weeks mm-hmm. right across the top, which that's the one I seem to live in a lot, because it shows what's going on all those weeks. And gives you a lot of information, and it's easy to stay right there.
Yep. And this is what Lauren is talking about. This has, up at the top for every meeting, a yes, no, question mark button that you can pick to say whether or not you'll be there. So if you like to plan ahead, this is the screen for you. Lorna was an accountant. I'm a paralegal by nature. Yeah. This is the screen that we use.
Yeah.
The artists in the room probably won't do this, but yes. The Lornas and Mills of the world will do this. Any other questions before we move on to speeches? All right, speeches. When you first join, you're assigned a mentor, and your mentor will work with you and help you prepare for your first speech. Our Vice President of Education, Doug, is responsible for actually scheduling your speech. When you've worked with your mentor and you'd like to put your speech on the calendar, you need a way to tell Doug, I'd like to do my speech on this day. That's where Easy Speak comes in. But what we do is we request a speech through this system. It will notify Doug, and Doug will put you on the calendar. And keep in mind that Doug is juggling speech requests for all 28 of us. And we have two or three speakers in meeting. We always have spots, but he does have to shuffle a little bit, so he needs to know if you'd like to speak. Okay? So here's how we tell Doug, I'd like to give a speech. From a meeting, over here on the left, we have my participation, and we have request a speech. When you hit request a speech, you get this pop-up. And this is how you give all of the information for your speech that goes on the agenda. The pop-up starts on the speech title tab. And you type in your title and the introduction. So you notice before I got up here and spoke, Lorna talked a little bit about me. That's what the introduction is. The title is what appears on your agenda, and in this case, my speech title was Easy Peasy. Make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So we put that in Easy Speak here. That's on the speech title tab. Then we go to the workbook slash speech tab. There are hundreds of possible speeches that you can give. We start out with the Competent Communicator Manual, which is 10 speeches. But from there, there are hundreds of other speeches you can give. So, we have to tell this which speech we're going to give. This drop down here gives us a list of all the books that we have right now. And keep in mind, guys, when Pathways comes, this is all changing.
Is Easy Speak going to be updated?
It is. They're going to update it for Pathways.
Are they?
Yes, I already talked about them.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Awesome.
So, you pick whatever book you're working from right here. If you're a new member, it will be the Competent Communication Manual, and that's the first one on the list. If you've finished your Competent Communicator Manual, then you have all of the other options. Entertaining speaker, presentations, motivational speeches, all that stuff. So let's say we're doing our very first speech. So we go to the Competent Communication Manual, we click that, and then it will give us a list of all the 10 speeches in that manual. And you click the little radio dial next to the speech you'd like to give. So for your first speech, it's the icebreaker, I want to give my speech number one. If you're on your fifth speech, you would hit number five, Your Body Speaks. Make sense? Next, the preferred date tab. When do you want to give your speech? It's kind of important. This tab gives you a list of all the upcoming meetings. And over here, you have radio buttons for first, second, and third. You use those to tell Doug what your first choice is for a night to give your speech, what your second choice is, and what your third choice is. That way, when he's trying to juggle people, he's got a couple options for you. So you just click the little buttons and tell him, I'd like to do it my first choice, best case scenario this night, second choice here, third choice here. Make sense?
Yes.
Okay. When you've got all three tabs filled in, title, workbook, and the date, you hit the little save button up at the top. Yes.
What are those little icons in the...
Oh, the yellow guys?
Yeah, yellow guys?
That is a great question. Dennis asked what these yellow guys are. These yellow guys tell you what's happening at that meeting. So here you'll see that there's some red text here. It says meeting full. These two yellow guys means there are two speakers already scheduled, and the meeting is full of speakers, so don't request that one. That's why it's got the red text and the two yellow guys. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So if you wanted to give a speech that night, you're probably out of luck unless you can get somebody to trade with you. or we can do 4 speeches, which we have done. So that doesn't necessarily mean, no, you cannot speak that night. It means ask Doug. Make sense? Mm-hmm. All good? Okay. Thank you for asking, Dennis. All right. You can also use Easy Speak to set a goal for yourself, and it will track that goal. Remember over here, we're on my participation, and this bar will always be here. This doesn't change. You can say, view my speech progress, and it will show you the speeches you've already given. Now, this is an account for somebody that has not given any speeches. But once you've given speeches, right here, it will list in the speech title and when it's been completed. So if you ever lose your book, if your dog eats it, if you pull a Gary and spill coffee all over it, we have a backup. It's okay. We can recreate it from this list. If you pull an Earl and swap out all your speeches, then you have to tell the VPE. You can also use this screen to set your goals. So up here, we have communicator goals. And when you do that, it pops up this little goal box, and you can say, I would like to achieve my competent communicator award by this day. Save it. And once you've done that, the goal will appear up here, and it will tell you how far you are along the path to that goal and whether it thinks you're likely to hit it or not based upon how often you speak. Make sense? Any questions on scheduling speeches? I'm moving on, so. Okay. When you serve as Toastmaster, you're responsible for this whole meeting. It's a lot of work. The only thing you're not responsible for is the speakers, because Doug does that. But when you are the Toastmaster, you need to fill all the roles, and you have to print the agenda, and the speaker intros, and you have to make sure that the speakers remember to put all their information in and that it's accurate, so on and so forth. So when you're the Toastmaster, the meeting in Easy Speak looks a little bit different. You have a lot more tools available to you to use. This is what a meeting looks like when you're the Toastmaster. So instead of just the little thumbs up buttons, you actually have a drop down next to each role. You can use those, but I got ahead of myself. You also have at the top the meeting theme that you can set. So you notice tonight our meeting theme was on your marks. You type that in there. And the trick here is you always have to remember to hit save. I've done that many, many times. Type it in, forget to hit save, you lose it.
And there's more than one save button on
yes,
that page.
You
want to bring that out
because
I've lost some stuff.
Yes, save it often.
I thought one save would be tough, but it wasn't.
Nope. So you can put in the meeting theme right there. Which, as the Toastmaster, you are responsible for selecting the meeting theme. And then you can use these drop downs to assign people roles. So if you have roles that aren't filled, nobody's volunteered, which is very typical, you can just start putting people in. You're the Toastmaster. You have the power. That's what happened tonight, and that's why you notice even on the agenda we have some names that have question marks. Those question marks, as Earl mentioned earlier, mean that Lorna as Toastmaster put a name in here, but that person never signed into Easy Speak and said, yes, I'm okay with that. Right? So when you use this, you get a drop down with all the names of our club members. Now this drop down can be really confusing because it's not in a very easy to follow order. It starts alphabetically, but then it drops people to the bottom of the list who have done a role recently or who already have another role at the meeting. So sometimes you may have to scroll through this list for a minute to find the person you want. It gets a little confusing. But when you find the person you want, you just click on their name, and they will show up with the exclamation point saying, look at me, in Easy Speak in the meeting. Now, when anybody else looks at this meeting, it will show Beverly in here as humorist with a question mark. Meaning she's in here, but she hasn't confirmed yet. Make sense?
Yes.
All right. When you are the Toastmaster, you're also responsible for printing the agenda and the speaker introductions. So the speaker intro is that little bit that you put in when you request your speech for the Toastmaster to read before you start. When you're the Toastmaster, you can print those by just hitting this speaker intro button right here, and it will pop up a new screen with those intros for you to print. To print the agenda, you use this button right above it, and that will pop up the agenda in a new window, also that you can print. And sometimes the agenda will run to 2 pages, but you should be able to shrink it down to 1 in your printer settings, hopefully.
I have a question.
Yes.
How many copies of the agenda should those masters print?
How many people are here tonight? 18, I think? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, 18. Yeah, we have about 19 here. I usually print 25. We have generally anywhere from 15 to 20 people in a meeting. There have been meetings where we have randomly had 8, 10 guests just out of the blue show up. So we had our usual 15 to 20 members, and then we had 8 to 10 guests as well. And we were scrambling and adding tables, and we didn't have enough agendas. So I always try to print at least 25 so we have some extra. As you are working on scheduling, there's a couple little tools in here as well. One of them I don't have a picture of, but when you click on the names over here, if you click just on the name, a little window will pop up that gives you that person's phone number. So if you're the Toastmaster and you're going, gosh, I wonder if Ed will be my listener, but I don't have his phone number. You do, it's in here. And you can call Ed, say, I'm Toastmaster this weekend, will you be my listener? The other thing that you can do is send a mass email. So from here, right up here, next to our speaker intro and agenda button, there is a smaller button right above it that says email. Using that email button takes you to this screen, which will send a pre-scripted email to the whole club. That's the first email. And all you have to do is hit first email, and it sends it. Everybody knows what this email looks like, right? Get this email all the time. Okay. From there, there's more customized emails, and you can see on the top, second email has a description, third email has a description. So for instance, the second email says, thank you for confirming or not confirming. I have not assigned you a role. The third one says, I have assigned you a role. So as the Toastmaster, what you can do is go through the meeting list, use the drop-down menus to put people in every role, then come to the email list, hit this third email, and it will send an email blast to everyone who you just dropped in a role saying, Dan, I just put you in as A counter, and Zahara, I just put you in as timer. And it will send those emails, and from that email, that person can say, yep, I'm okay with that. And we've all gotten those emails, right? All of us members, you know which email I'm talking about.
And each of those emails are modifiable. You can add to.
Mm-hmm. Sure. The standard text is in this box right here, and you can type in this box to change it. But it will autofill the names and autofill in the buttons. You don't have to mess with that at all.
If you saw the email that went out that Doug sent on my behalf, because I'm not solid on this part yet, he sent out an email saying, some of you have been assigned roles. Please go look. Because it's a surprise. But that is a heads up. And it's really helpful if people do that.
It is, yes. It's very helpful. Linda.
Question. If I sign up for Timer, for example, would it also send me an email saying, I slotted you in as Timer?
Depending on which email it could, yes. Sometimes there are reminder emails.
Okay. Does the Toastmaster determine whether those emails go out?
Yes. The
Toastmaster. So you might or you might not because of what the
Toastmaster depends on the Toastmaster.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah. And the other cool thing the Toastmaster can do is this bottom one here is a mentor email. So, for instance, Sanjay is giving his first speech tonight. If the Toastmaster sent this mentor email, It would send an email to Sanjay's mentor that says, hey, Sanjay's giving his first speech tonight. And your mentor, which they should already know that, but just in case they were falling down on the job, they would get an email saying that. Did I see another hand somewhere?
That was me. You answered this.
I did? Okay. Great. All right. That's everything that I have. Are there any final questions? Remember, guys. Oh, yep.
How often the site goes down or maintenance?
I've seen it down once or twice in 4 years.
You guys trying to enter 2-0 goes down.
Really? Okay. And as we as we get to pathways and he's doing more maintenance on it, we may see that a little more. The story behind EasySpeak is it's not official Toastmasters. It's a man named Malcolm out of the UK who got bored one day and decided to make us all a website that hundreds of clubs now use. This is just his side project thing that he does. And it costs him a bunch of money to keep it up and running, and it's free, but we sometimes make donations. Gary.
How does a new member obtain a username and password?
Doug will email it to them. And if he doesn't email you your username and password, new members harass Doug. Or any officer, and we will harass him for you.
I just want to say, under the present system, it's a good way for you to keep track of your the roles that you have accepted in the past in case you somehow lose your manual or something. It's, if you're diligent about putting your information into EasySpeak, or if your VPE is diligent about updating it.
Mm-hmm. And we have had that happen. Any final questions? All right. I hope I have inspired you all to go home. Get the hardest part over, log in.